it's really incredible, and I'm so proud to be part of it and proud to be Pacific Island myself. Representation on screen absolutely matters. If you haven't experienced what it's like not to be represented, then it wouldn't be such a big deal. But for Pacific Islanders and the Asian community and any other minority, so to speak, it means a lot. My name is Uli Latukefu, and I'm playing Dwayne the Rock Johnson before he was the Rock.
So I play Atta Johnson. She is the mother of Dwayne Johnson and the wife of Rocky Johnson.
My character is Leah Mavia, and she is Dwayne Johnson's grandmother, maternal grandmother.
My character's name is Sika Anuai, and he is one half of the wrestling tag team champions, the Wild Samoans.
I pick up after Dwayne is at high school and he's in college at the University of Miami. It's him working his way through trying to make the best of his football career, and he gets injured, unfortunately, as we saw in episode 4, and then it's him basically trying to work out what to do next with his life. Well, first of all, I had a Zoom meeting with Dwayne and kind of had a few scripts, and then had a meeting with him and really just asked him a lot of the questions that I had about what he was like during that age and kind of what motivated him. And he was an open book. He pretty much told me everything that I needed to know. And then it was about getting in shape, putting on as much weight as I could, as much muscle as I could, and just kind of really getting into the shoes of a football player who wants to be the best they can be.
We met via a Zoom call, speaking with her, just kind of tuning in a lot to the videos and things that Dwayne has posted about her. There's sort of limited footage and things of her when she was younger, so it was really just kind of tuning into who she is now and kind of piecing that together with the conversations that we've had.
One of the things I found really hard was the fact that you didn't know what these people sounded like. And so when I found videos of them, because those guys didn't really speak English, they only spoke Samoan, all you ever heard of them, the few interviews that you could get was, when they were still wrestling, was they were speaking Samoan. Brian from 7 Bucks, he was like Dwayne's producer rep down there, and they said, "Hi, have you any questions for Dwayne? Then just let me know, and I'll ask him." And I just had one burning question, and I was like, "I've got a question for Dwayne." And I was like, "Did your uncles ever speak Samoan to you?" And then the next day, Brian comes over and says, "Hey, DJ got back to me. He said, yeah, they did speak to me in Samoan all the time, and they're often telling me to hurry up or get something." And I was like, yes, I got it. Yeah, I know exactly what their relationship is.
They sent me a dialogue, which was only about 2 minutes. So all I wanted to know is what was her speech, how did she sound? But otherwise, there were newspaper clippings, and so I really didn't know much about, and there wasn't much written about her. So it was pretty difficult until we had the Zoom meeting with Dwayne Johnson and his mother, Atta. And a lot of information came from then. And just by their describing his grandmother and her mother, I thought, I can do this, because, you know, being of my age group, I'm over 60, and she sounded like my mother, who was tough, and, you know, she didn't really take much from anybody. So I thought, yeah, I can do it. You know, when we had the Zoom meeting, I thought, I'm going to be professional, and I'm not going to be like a fangirl and just go ridiculous. And so just get over the starstruckness and just get on with the job, you know, and do it well, find out as much as I can. But just to be asked and then to be chosen from, you know, the greatest entertainer, entrepreneur, business person in the world. I'm still going on about it, and yet it's over.
The audition scene was a scene that ended up being in the show, but it was like she was coming out and she was singing a song, and I was like, oh, okay, yeah, cool. And, you know, sort of did the audition for that. And then as I sort of tuned in a bit more into who she was, I was like, oh, okay, she sings a lot. She plays the ukulele a lot. She's really good at it. As early as I could, I got my hands on the ukulele. You actually pick it up quite quickly. Like, I was surprised. And I was even more surprised at how much I actually enjoyed it. Like, because I was kind of in Australia and a lot of times just by myself in the hotel or whatever, I found myself kind of turning to it as like a, it was actually very therapeutic. It's not about how good you sound or anything. It's about the fact that she, this is something that Uta would bond with her father over. And once he had passed away, it was a way for her to reconnect back to him, back to those memories of, you know, their culture and Samoa and just the enjoyment and everything that she found from it. I didn't want to go into it thinking, oh, you know, I need to be an exact replica of who she is. It was more about focusing on, you know, what was driving her and kind of like her decision making around raising Dwayne and stuff. You know, knowing that she's still alive and watching the shows and things. So we got a nice message from her after the pilot aired and she was really happy with it. That was a nice thing to receive.
You know, this story is very important to him. It's not just about Dwayne, but it's about his family, you know, his family's legacy. So for me, the weight of that was pretty incredible. That being said, you know, we had wonderful directors and writers and creators who were just like so talented, and Dwayne, you know, we were in good hands, so there was no problem.
I think shared experiences around making sacrifices for your child, and I guess struggle and hardship and not necessarily having all the money in the world, things like that, is definitely things I can relate to. And it was interesting because in the last block with Uli, he asked me at one point, he said, how's it been like being having to be a mum with these three different actors? And I said to him, like, it was actually a lot easier than what I thought it was, because the boys are actually very alike in terms of their, just like their energy and their spirit and what they bring to the role. Like, they're actually very similar. They're all lovely, gorgeous, gentlemen, the best bunch of guys you could work with. Like, they're just amazing.
But yeah, we flew in together and did quarantine together, texting and messaging, video calling during quarantine and all that kind of stuff. And then we got out and yeah, like I said, outside of filming, we hung out a lot. I don't want to sound cliche, but it felt like family.
On set, when I look around, my friend Stacey's playing Uta, and Stacey and I, we were in drama school together, and John was a year behind me at drama school, who plays Uta, and seeing Anna, who's playing Mama Leah, you know, we met her, we've done plays and stuff together, you know, for a long time, and just seeing all these people, all these Samoans, you know, it was not just, yeah, it was a big moment, because so often we have to play other people, you know, like, and it was so cool to see characters that were written that were actually Samoan people doing these things. And it's, yeah, so it's really cool.
You know, look to my left and there's a Samoan woman and another Samoan woman. And, you know, it's really incredible. And I'm so proud to be part of it and proud to be Pacific Island myself, because it means we're moving the right direction. And there's so much representation on screen, absolutely matters. If you haven't experienced what it's like not to be represented, then it wouldn't be such a big deal. But for Pacific Islanders and the Asian community and any other minority, so to speak, it means a lot.
You know, I would like to think that I wasn't chosen because I'm a Pacific Island Samoan woman. I would have liked to be chosen for my merits and my talent. And I would hope that the rest of my peers would have been chosen the same way. And they're the best. They are the best in New Zealand. They are the best. We're fortunate that we're with Pacific people, but we're also great actors.
We want to play, you know, we want to be part of this too, you know, like, and not just that, but we can do it, you know. It's not like we can't. And so hopefully, if anything, artistically, that this show demonstrates that. We, Polynesia, Micronesia, the whole Pacific Islands is a small group, I would say, but we have a lot to offer. Big hearts and, you know, a whole lot of love.
And of course, Uli, just met Uli, and I thought, couldn't wait to meet this great big hunk of a man. Oh, I shouldn't say that. It's